फ्रेंड, इट इज़ मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ क्लास 12 केमिस्ट्री, चैप्टर 1 सॉल्यूशन, एंड द टॉपिक इज कोलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टीज। कोलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टीज दैट्स मीन द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन। द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ सॉल्यूशन विच डिपेंड्स अपॉन द क्वांटिटी नॉट द नेचर ऑफ सॉल्यूट एंड सॉल्वेंट are called colligative property, and colligative property that is denoted by delta, it depends upon quantity and inversely proportional to the molecular mass of the solute. Means if you have added 1 gram of solute in any liquid, the property depend upon the mass of the solute, and it will change on adding 2 gram, 3 gram, 5 gram. It show the different property. As you see, whether you take 2 gram water or 5 gram water, the freezing point of water will be zero. Whether you take 5 gram water or 10 gram water or 1 kg water or 10 quintal water, there should be no change in the freezing point density of water. That's mean these are not colligative properties. There are only 4 colligative property. One is relative lowering of vapor pressure. Number 2, elevation of boiling point. Number 3, depression in of freezing point. Number 4, osmotic pressure. So what is the relative lowering of vapor pressure? See here, according to the Raoult's law, when we add any non-volatile solute in solvent, vapor pressure decreases. Suppose you have taken a solvent here. In this time you have not added anything, this is a pure liquid, so its vapor pressure will be maximum and indicated by P0 or P0. On the addition of solute, if solute is non-volatile, so according to the Raoult law, vapor pressure of solution, that's mean this composition, will decrease and indicated by PS. Why this is lower than this? Because when you are taking single solvent and vapors of this will be more. On addition of these solute particle, which cannot be changed into vapor, will not be formed in the vapor form on heating. It is clear that due to this, these solute particles vapor pressure is lower. When we add solute, the mole fraction of solvent decreases, that's why vapor pressure of solution decreases. So vapor pressure of solution is directly proportional to the mole fraction of solvent. This is the Raoult law. And if we write like this, PS is equals to P naught into X solvent, that's our mole fraction of solvent. When a solution is prepared, there are two components, solute and solvent. The mole fraction, sum of mole fraction of solute and solvent, that will be equals to 1. So here we can write PS is equals to P naught 1 minus X solute. On solving this, you will get P naught minus PS upon P naught is equals to X solute. P naught is the vapor pressure of pure solvent, PS is the vapor pressure of the solution. PS is little less than P naught, so we can say in this place del P upon P naught, or you can say lowering of vapor pressure of del this del P. When we divide this del P by P naught, so this whole portion is called relative lowering of vapor pressure. That will be equals to mole fraction of solute. What do you understand about this? Relative lowering of vapor pressure is equals to the mole fraction of solute. Mole fraction depends upon the mass of the solute and solvent. That's mean relative lowering of vapor pressure depends upon the mass of the solute and solvent, and is the colligative property. This is the first colligative property. In this property, we can calculate the molecular mass of unknown solute, or you can find the vapor pressure of the solution. The method used for the measurement of vapor pressure of the solution is Ostwald dynamic method. In the next topic, in the next video, we will discuss about the numerical problem of this. So be continue, subscribe this channel and comment in the sections. Okay, thank you, have a nice day.